What's up, everybody? It's Vlogmas day 5. And I missed yesterday. I know. I'm so sad. I was working all day and it was so busy with work that I didn't have time to vlog. And if I did have time, I wasn't doing anything interesting. So didn't want to vlog that. So hopefully you guys understand. But today is another boring vlog because I just worked. But I thought instead of just skipping Vlogmas, I'll just sit down and talk to you guys because why not? So first of all, I wanted to say I hope you guys enjoy my Europe vlogs. I still have 2 more that I need to edit and upload, so watch out for those. Maybe I'll do those as one of my Vlogmas days, which doesn't really work, but that's okay. As long as I'm releasing videos, which is my goal. So, secondly, I have 3 tips. After going on that trip, Arthur and I learned quite a few things just with planning the trip and what to do and what not to do. So I thought I'd share that with you guys. It might be specific and you guys might never go to those places that we went to, but for those of you who do, it might be helpful for you guys. Tip number 1, book your trains ahead of time, which might be obvious for all of you, but for us, it wasn't. Arthur thought we could get away with booking it like the day before or while we're there or on our trip or in the train station, and we realized that's not a good idea, but we didn't realize that until it was too late. So the night before we were going from Monopoly to Switzerland, we were online booking our tickets. They were costing so much money and it was so stressful. So you can just avoid that stress if you just book online before you go. Sometimes it's hard because you don't know where you're gonna go or what route you wanna take, but if you can figure that out at least and book those train tickets ahead of time, it'll save you time and money and stress because it's no fun doing that last minute. Also, in the Airbnb we were staying in that day, it was in Monopoly and the Wi-Fi was horrible. So we sat in the doorway, which you couldn't really move, and there was a tiny little space. And so we ended up both cramming in there, both on our, I had my computer, Arthur had his phone, and we were just trying to find deals and book tickets. And we ended up spending like a couple $100. And it was like 5 trains that we booked, and it took all day the next day to get us to where we were going. And maybe if you book ahead of time, the schedule will be a little better too, because we were kind of caught and didn't have too many options. So that might be obvious for some of you, but I hope it helps at least someone, because I wish I would have known that before we went on our trip and before we waited to book train tickets. Number 2 for my advice for you guys is if you're going to the Amalfi Coast in Italy, or if you're going anywhere in Italy, I don't know if renting a car is the best idea. Italian drivers can be crazy, which so can American drivers, so I'm not saying anything about that, but the roads in Italy are just really small, especially in the smaller towns, and it's kind of terrifying driving. There's no real lanes, and everyone just kind of cuts in front of each other, and there's just no rules, there's no traffic lights that we saw while we were there, and so that was kind of stressful. So if you can just book trains, book ahead of time. But I think booking trains is probably the way to go in Italy at least. But if you want an adventure, go ahead and book a car, but not in the Amalfi Coast because it's terrifying. So we drove from Naples, we flew into Naples and went to the Amalfi Coast, and the drive to Amalfi was okay. It was super windy and curvy and kind of scary, but once we got to like the edge of the Amalfi Coast and we were driving to our Airbnb in Amalfi, it was like right outside of Amalfi, that part was so scary. The roads are so narrow when you're driving on the Amalfi Coast, and the drop down is like hundreds of feet down. And there's only room for 1 car, but there's giant tour buses that come zooming around the corner like constantly, because that's how people get from place to place on the Amalfi Coast, which I would trust the bus drivers more than I would trust our driving. So I'd recommend skipping the carb. Arthur loves to drive like he's a race car driver. So he would zoom around the corners as buses were coming in. It just caused some unnecessary stress altogether. So I'd recommend taking the buses they have there or a train or whatever you can, a ferry, but maybe not the car. My third thing of advice is try and get the form of currency in the airport before you leave the airport to go out into the town. It just saves you a lot of time and stress. And most times it was easy to use our credit card, but when we got to Italy, and especially in the Amalfi Coast, we forgot to exchange money, and we were 2 hours away from any airport, so we decided to go to a bank. But that day we left, we didn't have our passports. We left them in our Airbnb because we didn't want to carry those around in case something happened. So we didn't have our passport and we only had our credit card, and we had like a $20 bill, which this was our fault. Maybe you guys will be smarter, but that's all we had. And so we took a ferry to Positano. We could pay with credit card. That was fine. And then we decided we wanted to take a bus back to Amalfi, where our Airbnb was. And the buses only take euro, which should be common sense, but to us, we didn't think about that. And so it was getting late, and so we tried to exchange our $20 or try to get money from an ATM, but we only had our credit card, not our debit card. And so we went into the banks and we tried to exchange our money, but they wouldn't let you exchange money unless you had your passport. So that wasn't an option. And then all the other banks that, or currency exchange places, they close at like 3 p.m. And so we couldn't go to any of those. So that was super stressful too. And so we're trying to exchange money before the last bus for the night comes. And we ended up not being able to find a place, so we ended up rushing back to the ferry, paid with our credit card for 2 ferry tickets back, and we ended up getting on the last ferry of the night with like 2 minutes to spare before we had to get on the ferry. And so it was just horrible. And then the next day we went to Ravello, which is another small town on the Amalfi Coast, and we tried to exchange money there, but by the time we had gotten there, the banks were closed because we drove there and it took forever to find parking. Another downside about driving on the Amalfi Coast is there's no parking or very little parking anywhere. So we finally found a place to exchange money and get euro. And it was such a hassle, but it worked out in the end. But note to self, and you guys should take note, get euro in the airport or get whatever currency in the airport. And maybe that's another common sense thing, but these little things that come up when you're just in the zone and you're just traveling and you're not always thinking about what you need, what to book, all this stuff. And so if you can just prepare yourself as much as possible without like preparing it to a T where you have to be here and here and here at a certain time, allowing some flexibility, but also being prepared for situations where you might need euro, or you might need to book a train, etc. So I hope you guys learned from my mistakes, and I hope this helped you a little bit. Anyways, you guys should really go to Europe if you can, because it's amazing. A lot of people can't because it's too expensive, but we ended up booking our flights for, I think it was like $400 total for 2 people round trip, and that got us from the States to Copenhagen. And then within Europe, it's pretty cheap to fly to different countries, not the train, unless you book ahead of time. And there's a lot of Airbnbs and hotels and hostels that are cheap. So you really can make Europe doable. I'm so thankful we went, and I'm so thankful we were able to. Anyways, that's it for today. Hopefully you guys learned something, and hopefully I helped you a little bit. Stay tuned for tomorrow. We'll see what tomorrow's video brings, but thanks for watching. Bye.